Hi folks, James here from Usher Plant Care. Today I'm out in Central Park in New York City. We're scouting for some beech trees, see if we can find some early symptoms of beech leaf disease. It's a disease you may have heard of. It showed up on Long Island a few years ago. And since a lot of our forests have plenty old beech, it caught our attention. It's taking out healthy, seemingly healthy trees in a matter of a few years. And of course, many folks have ornamental beech on your property, which are also at risk. So let's see if we can find some symptoms of the disease that you can look out for in your neighborhood. So beech trees in Long Island are just kind of starting to leaf out this time of year. But just a little further west here in New York, foliage has been popping out for a few weeks. So we have some more developed leaf growth, which will be useful for us today, since all the symptoms we are looking for really have to do with the leaves of beech trees. And the first thing we're gonna look for is really a low output of new foliage. Sometimes there is very little new foliage, or just less than average. Sometimes it looks a little distorted. And it's easiest to see that when comparing it to a healthier beech tree. Seeing them side by side, you can see what healthy growth looks like and what this diseased output looks like. So let's see if we can find some of that. Okay, so lucky for us, I did not have to look very far. The very first beech tree I came upon out here seems to me like it might have some of these symptoms. So I'm gonna start by showing you a seemingly healthy beech tree right here behind me. See, it's got the smooth bark that you recognize, and we've got a bit of leaves coming in already, starting to fill out. And I'm going to walk you 20 feet this way to a different beech tree. Let's see if I can flip this here. So literally 20 feet away is this beech tree, which I suspect may be suffering some beech leaf disease, because look at this output. Now we have some leaves popping here on a few branches, but the majority is pretty bare up there. So here it is behind me. You see a lot of bare twigs and small leaves. This, in comparison to the tree we just looked at, is doing pretty poor for output. And I would say that you can really notice branch to branch where the infection is spreading throughout the tree, because some branches will have leaves while some will be completely bare, which is somewhat unusual. So again, for contrast, here's another beech I've come across. Look at this crown of leaves, very full. Not all scraggly like that last one we saw. Let's keep looking. Hey, wax squirrel. All right, here we go. I think I found another good example here. There's one beech right behind me here. It's looking pretty good. You see his leaves are filling out, and right next to it, look at this one. Another beech tree in practically the same environment. We have some leafing out. We have lots of bare branches, very small leaves. This is one I would want to get checked out if it were on my property. So that stunted growth in the canopy is the first thing you can look for when identifying beech leaf disease. And I just want to quickly cover two more symptoms that you might be able to notice as the season rolls on into summer. Here's some fresh beech leaves. They're looking nice and new and healthy. And in the summer, you'll notice if there is this beech leaf disease present, striping or banding. Sections of this leaf will have dark stripes where you can't really see through to the sun. And that will be obvious from the ground usually. Also, distorted leaves become more obvious. Some just look off, they're a little twisted. Another thing to watch for late in the summer is that the infected trees will drop leaves earlier than healthy trees. So you might notice one beech is suddenly bald when one next to it is not. That's another symptom to watch out for. So what to do if you notice these symptoms on your beech trees? Well, luckily Cornell has been researching possible treatments over the last few years. They've had some success with three that they recommend now. One of those treatments meets our organic standard, So we are able to treat for beech leaf disease, but as with most disease issues and pest issues, happy and healthy trees are better at resisting the infection and better at dealing with it once they have it. So for that reason, we do compost tea fertilization along with a disease treatment. That just helps the tree stay healthy and fight off what it can on its own. If you notice any of these symptoms, get in touch with us at Usher Plant Care. We are organic land care professionals and happy to inspect for free. And if necessary, we will write up a program for you that includes the disease treatment and some compost tea fertilization to help these trees resist and bounce back. Good luck.